Hello everyone, my name is Vimala Ranganathan and I'm a Principal Product Manager in the Identity and Network Access Product Group. In this video, we will look at the user experience of Entra certificate-based authentication. To recap our certificate-based authentication settings, I have enabled CBA here for a group of users, CBA, which has two users. I have two users in this group. One is single factor test, which has single factor authentication string for the certificate. And I also have another user, MFA test, for which I have assigned multi-factor authentication string through this custom rule. So if MFA test comes with the policy OID 1234 in the certificate, they will get multi-factor authentication string, but it'll be using a high affinity binding, which in my case is a SKI. So let's look at how the user experience is. So I go to office.com. First, let's sign in with MFA test. As you know, MFA test user has multi-factor authentication string. I click on use a certificate on smart card. MFA test the certificate for that user. And if you look at the certificate information here, you can see under details, the policy 1234 is available. So this user should be able to get multi-factor authentication and sign in without having to provide another factor. Now let's look at another user, SF test, which has single factor authentication strength. So when this user tries to log in, the user should have to use another factor to sign in. I'm going to choose user certificate or smart card. And here you can see that it doesn't have 1234. So this user should have single factor. And for me, the second factor is my OPAP. So I'm going to use my phone and enter the code, after which you should see that the user has been logged in. Now to make sure that the users were authenticated using the right binding, let's go to sign in logs. In the sign in logs, there'll be a log entry with interrupted status. And when we look at that, we'll be able to determine what username binding was used and what values were presented in the certificate and how the user was authenticated. So let's wait for the sign in log too. So let's look at the single factor test user first. And if you go into additional details, you can see the value of the certificate that was used to authenticate the user. Similarly, let's look at one of the ones from MFA test. Here, there's an interrupted. Here you can see that this MFA test user was authenticated using SKI, and you can see the value that I put in the user object, and it also says SKI identifier, subject key identifier was used, and the user got a multi-factor authentication string and high affinity was used. So we can see that the user gets authenticated depending on the binding you have chosen. I want to show you one last thing in this is a thing called most recently used. In the first time when I logged in, you could see that I logged in by clicking the use a certificate or a smart card link. However, because I signed in once successfully, my most recently method has been set to certificate based authentication. So if I try to log in now, I would be auto accelerated into my MRU method, which is CBA in this case, and my cert picker would show up. So let's try MFA test. And here you can see I don't have to click on any link. It auto accelerated into my most recently used method. And once I selected the certificate, I am signed in. So it's as easy as that.